I am.
Awesome.
Thank you. Hi, good morning. Why, hello. Good morning. What's up, Perry people? If you're just joining me, my name is DJ Shannon C. I'm out here for a very early 5K that we're doing. I've been playing since 6:30 this morning. Man, this is not my life, really, usually. And I wanted to say hi to you guys. Hi, good morning. Check out some of our vendors that are out here today. Well, hold up, let me turn. Hi, good morning. All right, there you go. Oh, it's early.
She's almost done.
Hello.
I only have 7 classes.
I'll let y'all see what's going on here. Good morning, good morning. Hi, what's up, guys? Happy, I think we're at Saturday now. I've had a couple gigs a day for the past, 4 days. I have no idea what day it is. Hi, Turkey, what's up? I am not with the station. I am professional but independent DJ out of Tampa, Florida. I am affiliated with Scratch Events out of New York City. That's Jazzy Jeff's company, but I'm not with a radio station. Hi, good morning. Say hi to Periscope, guys.
Yeah, hello, Periscope.
Hi, good morning. Hello, Russia, what's up? Putting in that work, y'all know it. See, the thing about radio stations, and I would totally love to play for a radio station, but there's no money in it. And I'm out here in these streets trying to pay my bills, so I'm very strategic with the gigs that I take, because the whole point is to be out here in these streets trying to pay my bills. So, yeah, where do I play? And at live in Tampa. So I play in Ybor, I play in St. Pete, I play in Holiday, I play in Orlando, I play all over the place, y'all. Like, really, literally anywhere they'll book me, that's where I play. Check it out. The police are already here. Hi, good morning. We're gonna be keeping order. Hi, what's up, y'all? I got all my stuff loaded in, and like I said, I'm just gonna let y'all see. We are just getting going here. I'm not entirely sure what time this race starts. What I do know is that I'm booked from 6:30 to 10:30, and then I'm gonna break all my stuff down and fly like a bat out of hell over to the Tampa Premium Outlets, which is like an hour from here, so I can load in to my second gig. I play over there too. What's up? Hello, Kelly from Jordan. Hi, guys. Hold on, I'm gonna flip you back around. It's gonna get really loud when I... Hi, there we are. See, we're getting by my setup now. Hi, y'all. Hi, good morning. Early, so early. I'm not used to this kind of early, but you know, that good money pays good for these early gigs. When will I play? Well, technically I'm playing now, but it's an extended mix because I was getting all my stuff set up. And I had to, hi Connecticut, good morning, you up early. It's I had to get all my stuff set up and I had to get my car parked and moved and everything. Yes, I'm a DJ. There, I'm on my small gear today. Usually I bring my turntables out, but because I have another show very, very shortly after, I don't have time for all that. Hi Dallas, what's up? These are my biggest fans. You see them, they travel with me everywhere. Yes, that's what I'm talking about. I also have two sets of 1200 MK3s. One's my travel set, one's my studio set. And then you're looking right now at a DDJSR, which when I'm playing a gig where I have limited space, or when I'm playing a gig where I have to break down quickly like today, then that's my chosen route. Because man, you can add an extra 20 minutes for turntable setup, for real. And if you can play on MK3s, then you know. So I haven't got time for that today. I am out here this morning representing Impulse Entertainment. It is not my company, that is my boy Curtis. And he's got me out here hooking me up for this early gig. I do not like CDJs. I do not own them. I will play on them when I have to, but it's not my chosen medium. Honestly, I prefer the 1200s. If I have to play on something smaller, I rather a controller. And dude, that guy over there is really tall. I don't know if y'all can see him, but oh my goodness. So check it out. I've already been in this scary porta potty situation this morning. I don't even get down with porta potties like that. Today, so it's a family event, which really mainstream, really like top 40 family type music. So I play really open format and all over the place anyway. So, you know, I'll be looking around at my people and playing like probably some of the top 40 hits of the 70s, 80s, 90s, some stuff that's current now, some trappy remixes of some stuff that's current now. Impress me, you like vinyl, and you're gonna, yeah, man, now granted, I play on digital vinyl because I'm not trying to drag crates of vinyl around with me everywhere. I do have a couple crates of vinyl, but they stay at the house. They're more on display. And then I'm sort of obsessed with control vinyl. My CVs that I play on all the time are pink. How much do they pay DJs in the US in general? You know, that's a really pointed question, and it's really, it's dependent on a regional and also dependent on what kind of event you're talking about. So is it a private event or a nightlife event? Because there is a huge dollar amount difference between the two, like huge. That's why I don't do that many nightclubs, because they're cool, but they don't pay that much. So I really kind of like bank on these private gigs and retail gigs. That's where all the money is. You know, people are like, oh, but you're not that, you don't feel cool. But man, I feel real cool when I pay my rent. You know what I'm saying? Someone tap on the screen and give me some hearts for that one. So let me show y'all again. Yeah, right? That's what it's talking about. We're trying to pay rent out here. It's cool to be cool, but let's pay our bills. Let me show you what I got going on over here. I've got a mix going right now. Like I said, I just got set up here a little bit ago, and I've been kind of trying to get all the rest of it. Man, I had some cabling problems in the back. This speaker over here is not trying to work right for me today. It's not the speaker. It's the quarter inch in. I usually go XLRs. However, I don't have XLR inputs on the back of that SR. So my quarter inch output on this speaker, I've tried them both. I don't know what they're doing. I switched my cable because I thought maybe my cable was going bad, and I only had one 50 foot one left. So I got all this extra slack. Don't judge me for poor cable management, y'all. Usually I'm really clean with my setup, but bro, really? Hold up, y'all. I'm absolutely not gonna play dubstep in an event like this. That is a surefire way to get asked not to come back. Gotta know your audience, guys. I mean, yeah, dubstep is cool in the right scenario, but not at an event like this. And again, guys, it's about staying booked and getting paid. And you know, if you roll out here and you play what you wanna play, which is not appropriate for the event and not appropriate for the client, I promise you, you're not gonna get rebooked. You're gonna lose money. That's not what we're trying to do. Man, if they want me to play out of my wedding crates all day long, which is probably what I'm gonna be doing, to be perfectly honest, I will do it. I don't care, because guess what? It gets me rebooked, and that's what it's about. It's about making that money. What's the kit type? I don't think I understand. Oh, what's up, Massachusetts? Hi, good morning. I'm trying to have it going on, y'all. I'm trying. I'm also working on digitalizing some products for 2016. So if you're interested in learning to DJ, make sure you follow me. I'm gonna be releasing a how to DJ class, like a 101 class, coming up in early 2016, and then also a DJ for business class. And that's where I give you all my secrets on how I do this for a living. Because guess what, y'all? This is all I do. And I make more money than I made as a corporate trainer for JP Morgan Chase. Throwing that out there. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Hey, what's up, New York? How you doing this morning? I know it's early. You all are up so early. Man, if I wasn't here at this gig, I would still be in my bed cuddling with my dog. Yes, I always talk fast, and I get that a lot, and sorry if that's a problem for you. What is up, girl? I see you. How you doing? Make sure you connect with me. I mean, like I was saying, I don't really mess with radio too much just because I don't find there's a whole lot of money in it, but I'm always about expanding my network and expanding my exposure. So, like I said, if that's something you're interested in, you can find me. If you want to shoot me an email, you can catch me at djshannonc@gmail.com. Also, on like every form of social media, same deal, djshannonc on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Periscope, which is where you are right now. I think I'm on like LinkedIn and just everything, y'all, everything. Also, now let me, if SoundCloud is a DJ Shannon C, but check it out. SoundCloud's the devil, for those of you who know. So I'm on MixCloud too. That's a DJ Shannon C, but there's an underscore at the end because I'm trying to get my life right still. I gotta get that worked out. So like I said, if you want to follow me, you're welcome to. Like I said, appreciate you popping in and saying hello to me. I am not a morning person, so these AM gigs are so hard for me to get through. But I feel like if the money is good enough, man, I'll get up. It's cool. I was supposed to work a nightlife gig last night, and I actually had a friend cover it for me because I knew there was no way it was the club and then drive right to work today. That was not going to work for me. So, especially considering I've got two gigs today. Show us the CD players. They're not CD players, y'all. It's a controller. Check it out. It's the same concept, but it's all in one board, right? So, if you're used to CDJs, it might look familiar because it's made by Pioneer, and Pioneer makes the CDJs, right? But it's smaller, because see how it's all connected together? So, like, this would be your mixer, and then that would be each of your independent CDJs. However, because it's on a small board, it's all connected together. So that's kind of how that works. And like I said, I bring my fans everywhere because I live in Florida and it's really hot here. Also, girl, if I got Ebony catching me on the weird play, look at, I'm getting better about my life. This is breakfast. Not my usual, look, it's cinnamon roll flavored, but it's not an actual cinnamon roll. So I'm trying to do better. Trying to turn this flab to fab, y'all. So let me throw you back over here for a second. Thank you very much. And hey, I'm probably not going to remember that. So if you want to shoot me an email, it's djshannonc@gmail.com. Because like I said, I'm going right from this gig right to another gig. I've got a gig in Orlando tomorrow and I fly to Vegas for a week the day after. So honestly, I'm probably not going to go back and watch the replay because I'm not going to have time. But if you want to connect, absolutely email me. And hold up, y'all. All right, they've heard this Michael Jackson mix for like long enough. So I'm going to actually try to get my set for real started here. Hold up, let me get my headphones. Nobody that helps me move it. I do it all myself. That's why I was saying I chose not to bring my 1200s out today because I have a very short time period between this gig and the next gig. And so I can rip all this stuff down in probably 15 to 20 minutes. I also have labor. I have one of my friends I'm paying to come out and help me get from the gig one to gig two. Because gig two, the traffic's going to be terrible. It's at a mall and it's at a mall that just opened. So I've got an hour and a half between here and loading there. Yeah, it's going to be crazy. So, yeah, I do. I usually pull all this by myself. You know, my wish list for maybe 2016 is going to be, being able to have road help. Because, you know what, it's as a girl, it sucks to get my face all done and my hair all done. And then I've sweated it all out before I even start playing. I hate that. Ah, I hate it. And thank you so much. I really appreciate the compliment, God's chosen one. I try to have positive energy, and if I can spread it to anybody in any kind of way, then that's awesome. By the way, I used to have really cute hair like an hour ago, but y'all can't see it now because it's up in this like crappy knot because it's so hot out here. Y'all, I sweated out the curls that I put in my head last night. I don't even know why I spent the time. It's crazy. So hold up, let me sit you down, and I'm gonna start working on my thing over here so that y'all can see me mix live instead of just playing this mix. Alright, how about that? I can set you down here more, but all you're gonna see is the side of my... Yeah, sorry. Right now, I only play in the United States, but that's because I've never been invited anywhere else. So if you invite me and you pay me, I'll come. And of course, it's that time of morning where I got the sun like right in my face. What do we got out here today? I do travel, actually. Yeah, I'm going to Vegas, actually, starting Monday. I'll be there for a week. I'm going out there for my, my 21st birthday. It's not really. It's going to be my 32nd birthday, actually. Can't believe it'll be 32. Hi, what's up? Do I like turkey? I like to eat turkey, and I've never actually been to Turkey, so I can't really have an educated opinion, but I have no problem with turkey. I hear y'all got that good furniture over there. I gotta play something other than Michael Jackson, y'all. I'm tired of Michael Jackson already. Mm-hmm.
Make sure you check out all of our vendors.
I wish I was. I've got my Converse on, y'all. Thank you very much. I'm actually at 117 right now. This song is naturally at about 112, but I like to go up about 4 to 5% to keep my energy high.
Thank you. naughty, funky, fresh. With my body so melodic, this beat rolls right through my chest.
You're my BPM guy who was asking earlier. I'm down to 113 now. But you can tell the difference. Sounds slow.
Let me see you one, two, three. You crave it,
Jazzy made it.
So retarded, top charted. Ever since the day I started, stuck my stuff and yes, I flaunt it. Goodies make the boys jump on it. No, I can't control myself now.
Let me do my 1-2 step.
Good morning, everybody. Hello, hello, hello. Good morning. Welcome out to our 5K. I hope you guys are ready to get started. We are going to kick things off for you all in about 10 minutes, which means I need you to come over here by me in about 10 minutes. So here's your 10-minute call, guys.
Nation. Don't you dare. Move your arm around. I make me rub it, stick it, jam it, to read out.
Don't forget sex, no.
Who got the heart? challenge me have to touch on the fronty guy. So how you walk so shy? Me no make it him out me da like a blind. Why? So me like you took up high. Cause I, yes I believe you can fly straight through the sky. Between him and me, between the ties. In the Batman, I'm a Miller Robin guy. If you and I ever not to die. No shy, when me stop it then you reply. Bite your lips and close your eyes. Come, bumble, bumble against wall. We sex them out to death.
We want you to get started right over here.
Don't downtown planter, uptown pimp. You see this whip. Eddie Murphy red leather, pants on hammer, I'm too legit. Ooh, my hair so gorgeous, make them girls so sick. I wait in line, even Beyonce want this shit. I'm too hot, hot dance, I like myself on Instagram. I'm too hot, hot dance, I'm Jerome and Robin with a pin in hand. I'm too hot, hot dance, covered in gold, you know who I am. I'm too hot, hot dance, thank them jams for that motherfucker.
Education and transplant patient assistance in need for both the Legacy Fund and Donate Life Florida. Please look out there and speak to your individuals around there. A lot of the people wearing blue shirts have either received a transplant or a donor family or a LifeLink employee. If you're ever interested in volunteering for our cause, we would love to have you. You can go to our website, lifelinkfoundation.org, and visit there to get more information about our foundation too. Introduce Jennifer Krause, our Director of Public Affairs for the LifeLink Foundation. She's going to say a few words on behalf of Donate Life Florida.
Everyone, thanks so much for coming out so early in the morning and supporting this important cause. I am the Director of Public Affairs for LifeLink Foundation, but I also serve as the immediate past chair for Donate Life Florida. Donate Life Florida is a statewide coalition of organizations like LifeLink from across the state who are all in support of organ and tissue donation, and our job is to take care of Florida's organ and tissue donor registry. So when you go to the driver's license and you say yes to donation, or if you go online to donatelifeflorida.org and you say yes to donation, you are supporting saving lives throughout Florida through Donate Life Florida. We appreciate the Legacy Fund and LifeLink for putting on this event and making us a part of it.
Hear that, y'all go donate.
We hope you have a wonderful day and a great run. So thank you so much.
Yay. Thank you, Jennifer. I would now like to introduce Mr. Dennis Heinrichs. He is our president and CEO of LifeLink Foundation. He's gonna say a few words on behalf of the Legacy Fund.
Thank you so much, Holly. Beautiful day. It's delightful to see it, be in front of our LifeLink building, to see so many transplant recipients, donor family members, friends, colleagues, supporters, business colleagues, our good colleagues with the Lions Eye Bank, all here today. I'm saying a few words, if I could, about the Legacy Fund. The Legacy Fund is a very important part of the transplant programs for Florida and Georgia in particular. So we have members of our board from the Legacy Fund who are here. We raise money to support patient needs. So if you are a patient who has a transplant and there's care or treatment that maybe you can't afford, or God forbid you've lost your insurance or something like that, we're able to fill that, bridge that gap and provide the funding that will keep you in the game and in the run. So we're excited about that. Today is very special. It's the first ever. I hope the clouds stay with us all day, right? But the other thing I'll say this, the Legacy Fund's mission is growing. My hope is I'll see you again here this time next year for the second race, and that we'll fill the parking lot with runners and those of us who decided not to get a number and stumble kind of along. The last thing I'll say is this, is that the building you see behind you all the way back that doesn't have a big LifeLink on the front is the LifeLink Tissue Bank. And the LifeLink Tissue Bank this past year provided tissues in support of reconstructive knee surgery, back surgery, neck surgery. I think that means my time's up. No, if things you, something doesn't feel right, the one-stop shop right there, okay? So thank you all so much. So we have here with us today Christine Daniels. And Christine is a mom. And she gave the gift of life on the behalf of her son. And Christine is gonna come next. And she's going to cut the ribbon for the race, is my understanding. So Christine, please welcome this wonderful lady.
Thank you. In January of 2012, on Wednesday evening, my son was pronounced brain dead. Thursday afternoon, I walked beside my son for the last time to the operating room doors, where he would save four lives by becoming an organ donor. It doesn't get easier without your loved one, but you learn to live life differently and appreciate life. Out of that tragedy, I have become a volunteer with LifeLink, where I continue to share the importance of organ and tissue donation, as well as sharing the great gift that Chris gave to others. I have met his heart recipient, who is doing terrific. The doctors have told him that he could not have gotten a better matched heart. I have met so many wonderful people with so many terrific stories. I'm here today to encourage you all to become organ donors. If you're already a donor, thank you. If you're a recipient, I strongly encourage you each to reach out to your donor families. Thank you all, LifeLink staff members, medical personnel, and those who are here today to support donation. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Christine, for sharing your inspirational story. We really appreciate it. If anyone is not an organ donor and would like to sign up to be an organ donor, please visit the green tent over here. We'll have registry cards, and we can educate you on the organ donation process and how you can sign up. I would like to now invite Scott Kramers, our race director, up. Sorry, I caught him blindside a little bit. I'll tell you guys a little bit about the race. Just a few notes before you make your way to the starting line. The start line is actually not going to be right here. This is going to be our finish line. We're all going to congregate slowly. We're going to walk along the median. The entire race is along the median, or it follows the median. So make sure you stay within the cones and hug the median along the race. Just keep going. The start is going to be up here on the corner of Delaney Lake right there and Delaney Creek. So just follow the crowd. We'll lead you up there and we'll start from up there and we're going to finish over here. Awards will be given out to the top male, the top female, and the top child, 12 and under. Just a reminder, please be courteous and let competitive runners make their way to the front of the start line. We just want to make sure that if they're trying to get their best time, we want to make sure that they can. So strollers, joggers, walkers, please stay toward the back if you can. We just want to make sure that people who are running competitively are able to do so. There's going to be cheerleaders throughout the race course. There's also going to be a water station. Embassy Suites has provided volunteers for that, and that'll be halfway through the race course. Is Scott around here yet? No. It will be a shotgun start once we get over there, and I'm trying to think if there's anything else that we need to say. We would like to thank our bicycle marshal, Mr. Rodney Jones. Everyone give a round of applause for Mr. Rodney Jones. He's wearing a Donate Life outfit, and he is a living donor, actually. 5 years ago, he donated a kidney to his wife, and she's doing great. So we're really excited to have him as part of our event today. So if everyone would, we're going to make our way out to the start line. We're going to all congregate this way. We'll follow Mr. Jones out to the start line. But first, we're going to have Miss Christine Daniels cut our ceremonial ribbon, which is right up here.
Ready?
Ready.
We're going to lead over to the start line. Thank you.
Should be, and if you feel like donating, you can look them up. The name of the event is the Love Give Live 5K, and again, the name of the company is LifeLink. Wait for a second. Hi, what's up?